Okay, another oldie but goodie.
This is the story of Pete's dragon. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when you hear the chimes ring like this.
Let's begin now. Unless you happen to know Pete, you may not believe there really is such a thing as a dragon named Elliot. But there is. In fact, Elliot is Pete's very best friend. And this is the story of what happened to Pete and Elliot in a small town called Passamaquoddy. You see, Pete didn't have a mother and father to take care of him. He was an orphan. So Elliot decided he would take care of Pete himself. Elliot was a fine-looking dragon. He had lovely green scales and purple wings. Like all dragons, he could fly, puff up his cheeks, and breathe fire, and speak dragon talk. But Elliot could also make himself invisible. Not every dragon can do that. Pete thought his dragon was a perfectly wonderful friend.
You sure changed my life, Elliot. I didn't think I'd ever be happy until I met you.
As the two friends headed for Passamaquoddy, Pete said,
"Now, Elliot, we want people here to like us. But most folks are sort of scared of dragons at first. So you better make yourself a good one."
And with a skip and a bit, Elliot did just that.
"Remember,"
whispered Pete as they marched down the main street of town,
"behave yourself. And watch where you swing your tail."
In dragon talk, Elliot said he would be very careful. But a second later, he stepped right into a new sidewalk of wet cement. Whoosh, whoosh. Pete took one look at the footprints and moaned.
"Elliot, look what you're doing!"
Elliot quickly jumped out of the cement and accidentally smashed a picket fence with his tail. The noise frightened the egg seller and the milkman's horse. Soon there were broken eggs and spilled milk everywhere.
"Come on, Elliot. I've got to get you out of Passamaquoddy before you wreck the whole town."
Pete and Elliot ran toward the rocky cliffs along the coastline. Here stood the tall Passamaquoddy lighthouse, whose bright beam of light warned passing ships of the jagged rocks below. In the side of a cliff down by the pounding surf, Pete found a cave big enough for Elliot.
"We'll stay here for a few days."
And the two friends soon made themselves comfortable. Before long, Pete heard a voice calling from the cave entrance.
"Hello in there."
Elliot quickly disappeared as a very pretty lady peered into the dark cave.
"Hi, I'm Nora."
Pete smiled shyly.
"Hello. I'm Pete. This cave isn't a very nice place to stay,"
said Nora.
"Why don't you come up to the lighthouse and stay with my dad and me?"
Pete smiled.
"Okay, that sounds great."
As he left the cave, Pete whispered to Elliot,
"You stay here while I look around."
When Nora and Pete reached the lighthouse, a man with a white beard was waiting.
"Who's this young fellow, Nora?"
"Dad, this is Pete. He's going to stay here with us for a few days."
Pete shook hands.
"Pleased to meet you, sir."
"Just call me Lambie. Welcome aboard, Pete."
Early the next morning, even before Nora and Lampy were awake, Pete ran down the cliff to Elliot's cave.
"Nora swept,"
he reported to the interested dragon.
"And so is Lampy. I told them all about me, but I don't think they believe in me."
Pete was right. Nora and Lampy thought dragons only existed in fairy tales. One day, Pete came to the cave wearing a brand new suit.
"Hi, Elliot. Nora is taking me to start school today. Do you want to come along?"
Elliot sure did. He turned invisible and followed Pete to the schoolhouse. In fact, Elliot was so excited that he tried to talk to Pete through the classroom window.
Pete, who are you talking to?
Demanded the teacher.
I'm sorry. I was shushing my dragon, Elliot. When I ask you a question, young man, I expect a truthful answer. Now go stand in the corner.
From the look on Miss Taylor's face, Elliot could see that Pete was in trouble. Pete needs me, Elliot thought, crashing right through the side of the schoolhouse. The wall collapsed, and so did Miss Taylor.
Uh-oh!
Pete yelped.
Elliot's done it again.
Dragon boyfriend. It's true, it's true. Oh, what are we to do? It's true, it's true.
All that is in a stew.